The research on future crops is about finding new types of crops that can cope with the increasing population and extreme weather conditions that we're already facing today. This is Birgitte Skadhauge, Adjunct Professor and Vice President at Carlsberg Group Research Laboratory.
A lot of the research we are doing here, of course, we are doing quite a bit for improving malting barley for the brewing world, but we see that these kind of findings and experiments we are doing there can go much beyond that. I think it's very important that, you know, the industry and universities and the whole scientific community take the responsibility really to develop and make sure that we can supply the world, you know, the food we need for the future with the growing population, but also with the very challenging effects we'll have in our environment with, you know, more extreme weather conditions. And secondly, there are many, many possibilities also to use plants for different types of materials. It could be bioplastics, it could be for all kind of other materials that we need in our daily life. We are trying to make barley and use barley as a model organism because we have the full barley genome today. Over 10 years, we were a part of a big international consortium where we revealed the whole barley genome sequence, and that was published even on the front page of Nature.
Finding the genome of the barley plant was quite an achievement because this general understanding can help make a precise and dedicated development of crops for the future.
Where we specifically can select barley variants that's adapted for these different conditions, for example, cold climate in Greenland or even in the northern part of Scandinavia. And it goes also in the other direction, because hopefully we will also in the future have crops that has a much better drought and heat tolerance. So crops that's normally not can grow in these dry environments will be able to be adapted for these type of environments in the future.
Birgitte and her team also find a lot of inspiration from ancient crops like Chenopodium quinoa, a crop that the Incas started to cultivate more than 4,000 years ago, despite of challenges like a high salt content in the soil and very little rain in those growing areas.
So getting inspired by a crop that has these extremely favorable qualities is something that's very good as a scientist to look very closely into and understand. Then you should also be able to at least use some of them or maybe get inspired and then develop that in some of the major crops we are mainly using today.